But I want to make sure that our borrowed units do not actually die, so that's obviously a bit of a thing to worry about. Oh, hello there. Oh, I can't believe, what? What actually happened right there? Hello and welcome back to the Ronin. And now, we are in the smithy in a nearby town, and I have moved on from the previous one that we were at because I was thinking to myself that I was going to recruit a companion from there, but I personally felt like she didn't have the stats that we are really looking for, so I'm going to be a little bit pickier this time around with our companions, and hopefully we're going to find someone that fits the bill quite nicely. Anyway, as you can no doubt tell, I'm going to be doing a little bit of smithing right here, and as you see, we have 7 charcoal, so I can now start to get a little bit of wood back, and then we can just alternate between these things. Obviously, I'm not going to try and build anything that is too dramatically powerful, because that obviously imbalances the game in a pretty significant way, and obviously, I'm not frowning on that if people want to do that. I personally feel like more power to you if you want to take that route. It's just not something that I can really do for a series because a number of reasons. It just kind of imbalances things quite a bit. However, as I say, if you want to do it yourself, then go for it. You know, it's a game about player choice after all. Anyway, there you go. We were able to get our smithing to 22. Unfortunately, that is not enough. We do need to get 25 to be able to maximize our charcoal gain, and you can see here that I actually do not have enough to be able to do that. I don't have any hardwood either, which is somewhat unfortunate, but it's all right because we can smelt a couple of things here. Let's smelt some stuff because we have the ability to do so, and it would be quite nice to at least level smithing a little bit, and I'm talking about maybe to about maybe 75, something along those lines, maybe somewhere around there would be quite good, because if we can get it to that level, then we will have an opportunity to get a wide variety of different perks that may indeed help us in actual combat as well. It's been a while since I've taken a look at the smithing tree, so let me actually just take a quick look. I think there's something way to the right. Yeah, there we go. This is the kind of thing I'm talking about. It requires 150 in smithing though. Yeah, that's kind of unfortunate actually. That is insane. Artisan smith, trade penalty while selling smithed weapons is halved. Can you imagine that? Let's just say you make a javelin and it normally sells for 100,000 even without the artisan smith skill, and then you have that and you're going to be getting what? I don't even know what the trade penalty is for something that expensive, but yeah. Anyway, you can also see a number of other things over here, like for example increasing endurance at 225, gaining 1 focus point to one-handed and two-handed at 225, and so on. Yeah, you also gain a little bit of damage from crafted weapons if you go all the way to 250, and then when you get to 275, your character has a 5% chance to create a legendary weapon if difficulty requirements are met. This increases by 1% for every skill point beyond 300. So technically, I could maybe create a legendary weapon of some kind, and then we'll, well, have a grand old time, hopefully. Anyway, I'm gonna just go into the smithy real quick and see what I can actually make, because I'm wondering whether I can make katanas. I actually don't know whether I can, so let me see if that is even... Yeah, I don't have any of them right now, as you can quite clearly tell. I literally just have this, which is a long saber blade. Personally, I like saber blades quite a bit, but I'm trying to very much keep within the theme of this series so far. Now, I know that a bunch of people have said in the comments to me that using a crossbow is not really in keeping with the theme of a Ronin or samurai, Japanese warrior, whatever you want to, you know, call them, but that's the point. I know that. I do know that. But the main reason why I mentioned in, I think, the first episode is that a lot of people wanted to see crossbow gameplay. And I thought to myself, okay, you know what? I'm going to do a little bit of a combination. And that's the reason why we're using a crossbow. Because I'm using a crossbow with a faction mod, which I thought was extremely cool looking. And that's how this happened, basically. So hopefully that is to be expected. Okay. Wants you to beat the game. Okay. So apparently someone told me, I'm not entirely sure when, I think maybe like five, six days ago or something like that, in the Duelist series, there was a comment that said that this particular task, maybe it was actually longer, I think it was quite a long time ago, but this particular task, I hate this task. I personally don't like it at all. I think that the games, shall we say, quote unquote, games that are designed in Bannerlord are very confusing. At least they're confusing to me, maybe not to you. But generally, I feel like if you're going to make a game within a game, and it's a board game of some kind, or a card game, in the case of Gwent, for example, I think some people were actually talking about that as well in the comments. And if you're going to make something like Gwent, or attempt to, then it needs to be, it needs to have depth, of course, because otherwise if it's too simple, it's not going to be that fun, but it needs to also be understandable, and some of these games are not that. So, yeah, maybe there's something that can be done about it. Who knows? Okay, so here we go. So that comment basically said to me that I can just pay him the amount, and then I get double back, or triple almost in this case. As you can see, I literally just paid 1,000. Didn't have to play him in the Well, quite frankly, the stupid game that I do not want to play ever again. And there you go. I've now gained a profit of 1,700. And that is it. And now I am done. And now I can leave. It's kind of broken, actually. The quest seems kind of broken. So I think that's going to be changed later on down the line. Now, that's not to say that I have a dislike of having board games or whatever in the game itself, because I think it adds to the overall richness of the game world. And let's just say that you actually want to play like a gambler archetype or something like that, you know, where you're role-playing as like a gambler or something that travels from town to town, participating in tournaments, participating in duels, and indeed also participating in board games, gambling card games, you know, all that sort of thing. I think that could be a lot of fun and definitely very, very interesting, actually. That kind of wandering stranger kind of gameplay would be quite cool. But obviously, that's not how it is right now. So we'll see what happens with the, the development of the game, and hopefully it will go in a good direction. Okay, 13. Okay, I'll bring you at least 13. Do I have 13 actually right now? I am unsure. I think I might have. Ah, yes, I have 23. That is perfect. All right. So we will be speaking to him. And yes, I brought you a few men. Fantastic. Okay, so now I can basically just give all of these poachers. I don't really want to take these poachers into my army, because I don't think as you can see, they don't level up, so not really necessary for me to take them. And we need 13, so I'm just going to give him 17 and get a little bit of extra cash as a result. There we go, 2,500 charm, very nice. And now we can head onward, and we're gaining even more relation. All of this is just helping us to set an extremely solid foundation for the future when we actually get into these really, really large battles. Bear in mind that I think I might even be close to... no, I'm actually not close to it. Oh well. I was actually hoping that I'd be close to Clan Tier 2, but unfortunately I am not. So yes, anyway... Where's the nearest town now? Akuson. I will go over there immediately and try and see if there is a companion there, because if I can complete that particular quest, this one, establish your clan, I just need to hire one companion to be able to do that. We also need to train this guy's troops. I already have a number of them leveled up. I think I need to level up another 4 of them, yes. I need to level up another 4, so hopefully that will be done quite soon too, but it's kind of weird. I haven't really come across any bandit parties. I actually don't know why that is, but apparently I'm not coming across anyone. And also there aren't any companions in any of the taverns, which is also quite interesting. All right, so let's go and escort this caravan. I don't want to do that one. Thank you very much. I don't want to make a caravan myself. I don't even have enough for that. Okay, so it's 858 per day that the caravan is on the road. That sounds pretty good to me. Trained rogue, please join me. Thank you. And let's see what happens. There's only 12. This is a bit problematic. Having only 12 members of the caravan, that's going to be a little bit touch and go. So I need to stay right on top of them to make sure that they don't get murdered instantly, because combat on the world map does progress very, very fast, obviously dependent on the various, party sizes that are going to be clashing in battles. Because if they're, you know, attacked by a band of 30 or 40, they're going to die extremely fast. Is that it? No, they're traveling to Akalat. I thought to myself, was that it? That was a very easy... Huh, hello there. Okay, we're just, should I just auto-resolve this? I'm just going to auto-resolve it. It's very simple, look at that. That was super, super easy. And we gained some step bandits, which I'm not really going to be converting to join me, because I think I still need veterans' respect to be able to do something like that. But I think it's pretty fine to just take them, just in case we come across one of those quests where they need prisoners or something. Might make sense. All right, there we go. Good enough. Okay, yeah, but now, did you see exactly what happened there? I was a bit slow to even get into the fight, even though I was almost right on top of them. So being a bit more vigilant would definitely pay off. I think this is probably the final stop, though. So there probably won't be any other... Yep, there we go. That is indeed the final stop. Did I not get any additional cash? Where's my cash? You see that? Oh, 840. Was that it? Yeah, I think that was it. Okay. Seems like the messages just got spammed up because a bunch of people got taken prisoner and I didn't see it. Okay, well, that's good to know. Okay, so yeah, as you can see, these guys go into Marauders and then into Kuzate, and obviously I'm not going to be using Kuzate units at all in this series. So we're just going to go through to this tavern here. Really? Still not anyone? This is actually very strange. Okay, there's also no tournament going on here either. I was hopeful that we would be able to potentially do something like that, because it can give us 10 renown, because I have increased the amount of renown that you gain from tournaments using Bannerlord tweaks, because as I said before, I don't really want to be spamming tournaments in this series, because it is not a duelist series by any means, and it doesn't really make sense for me to do that. Ah, hello there, we have some... Ooh, this might be a good person to take. Oh, all right, this seems pretty nice. She has trade, she has steward, she has roguery. Roguery's not really that useful in my opinion, but she also has decent bow skill, which I'm very happy to see. So I'm gonna actually just recruit her. There we go. Whoa, 2,000? What? Why is she so expensive? And there we go, we completed the quest, and now we have this quest to do, which is actually not too bad. I think this quest is actually quite good. Rescuing our family is quite important, I suppose. And I am very much looking forward to getting Ica outfitted in the best possible stuff. It's actually kind of weird. She has a bit of a sort of Japanese name almost as well. I think that's kind of amazing. Wouldn't have expected to run into anyone... that had a somewhat accurate name in that sense around these parts, at least. Okay, so let's just give her some really good stuff. There we go. Okay, we need to. We don't have any gloves. Are you serious? I didn't have any gloves. Okay, well that's it's a little bit unfortunate. Oh, we do have these, which I suppose is decent. It's not really decent, but it will have to do for now, unfortunately for her. And she's using a rusty fine steel saber. I have a katana here, which is decent. It's crude, but it should do the job quite nicely for her. And we do need to give her a longbow as well, because of course she is indeed an archer at heart. So we're just going to be giving her two lots of quivers, and hopefully she's going to do a decent job. I'm actually going to take away her horse, because she is actually not a horse archer. She doesn't have a huge amount of riding skill, and if I just take a quick look at her skills, you can see that is indeed confirmed. She only has 2 in riding skill and 70 in athletics, so we'll just keep her the way she is right now. She's actually level 14. That's pretty high up. And we're going to be... what are we going to be doing here? I should probably level up my scouting. I should probably level up my smithing. I should level up everything, shouldn't I? Yes. There are so many different things that I can choose from right here. I should probably level up steward a little bit too, because as you can see, this learning rate is just about to go and, go in the dumps, basically. So I'm going to level this up a little bit, because having one of these is going to be quite important. 4 passive experience gain for tier 4 plus troops, and 2 passive experience gain for all troops. Garrison wages 5% less, doesn't really make any difference on that. However, food consumption reduction, workshops having 20% increased production, all that sort of stuff. Yeah, I think that could definitely be quite useful. Medicine's not really leveling up that fast. Not entirely sure why that is, but we're going to go for another point in intelligence anyway, just to give it a slightly bigger boost, and we'll see how that goes. Anyway, there seems to be, yes, the main quest over here, and we'll see how it goes. So what do I actually need to do? Yes, we need to go to the hideout here. Have I trained the troops yet? Because I don't really want to head in there and then have these guys die. No, we've got 3 left. Okay, that shouldn't be too bad. Ah, you finally arrived. I defeated you before. So let's do this. All right. Shouldn't be too long to wait either, because the night time is just about to come. And we can now move in. Obviously, again, I'm not going to be taking a huge amount of people into these... I have to take these troops in? Well, that's actually hilarious. Okay. They're locked, as you can quite clearly tell. There's a lock icon next to them. So unfortunately, I won't be able to take them, which is sad. I'm not entirely sure why not, but okay. And I will be probably not taking any tier 3 units. I'll take everything else. I want to not take these guys, but oh well. Okay, let's just take these guys away. Tier 4s. These guys are way too strong in my opinion. Don't really want it to be too easy for us, of course. 22. Let's just have 17 then, I guess. We'll just take in 17 units. As I said before, I don't really want to steamroll the bandit hideout with a huge amount of people. I might even go so far as to reduce the amount of people that we have coming in here by more of a margin later down the line. But I want to make sure that our borrowed units do not actually die, so that's obviously a bit of a thing to worry about. Oh, hello there. Oh, I can't believe, what? What actually happened right there? Alright, let's try that again, shall we? We're going in with 15 this time instead of 17. Maybe the 17 was like a bad omen or something like that for us. Well, I suppose we'll find that out in just a second. But I think that there were a number of factors that contributed to my demise in that particular fight. And I wonder whether you can, whether you've already seen what those were. Well, basically from my perspective, what it was I got shot from the right side by that guy over there, and then I also got murdered by someone with a mace, because I initially thought that I would be able to kill him without too many difficulties, and that in turn gave me way too much overconfidence, because I thought to myself, I'm gonna be able to kill this guy in 2 slashes. I got 2 slashes off on him, and that was not enough to take him out, you see. So that was not enough to take him out. So, in other words, we then had a retaliation against us, and boom, that was it. Because then I got shot again, and then I allowed another one of his strikes to go through, even though I actually thought I was blocking him. But, well, it happens, it happens. Sometimes there are lapses in concentration, and other times it is just because you're me, you know? Sometimes that just happens. Anyway, this is going a lot better this time. Unfortunately, because of the little lock icon, I wasn't able to remove the veteran borrowed troop, and as a result, one of them has now died, which is actually kind of bad. So, not a terribly big fan of that, gotta say, but what can you do? Can't do much about it, you know? If they force you to take those guys in there, then that's how it is. All right, where are my brothers and sister? All right. I will duel him. Let's do it. Okay. He's got a two-handed sword, which I should be able to outspeed really, really fast. Yeah. This guy's nothing in comparison to that other hideout boss. The other hideout boss was insanely strong. Anyway, there's 6 renown for us. Not too bad. I hope that we're actually going to get to clan tier 2 relatively soon. Okay, so there we go. There's the execution. As you can see, he's going to do it. He's going to do it. I can't stop him. He's just going to go ahead and, well, do the deed. And otherwise, what else do we have here? Nothing really much. I am actually having a bit of a problem that my money situation is actually going down quite a bit. All right, so they're going to go to Akalat, and that is absolutely fine. And Radagos is goodbye. There we go. You can actually punish him if you want. You can actually execute him if you so desire, if you feel like he's done wrong to you. But personally, I feel like it's fine just to leave him and for him to do whatever he wants to do. All right, so we have two different options right here. Decreasing our armor weight by 30%, or while on foot, your weapon handling is increased by 10%. Personally, I really don't know actually what is better here, because handling is obviously more offensive, whereas armor weight is more defensive, I suppose, because if you're able to move around just that much quicker, then of course you're going to be able to dodge a little bit more. Tier 3 plus foot troops in your formation gain plus 10% movement speed. I'm probably going to go for that, to be honest. I think that sounds pretty good, even though I'm probably not going to be on foot that often, because I do have a horse and I'd actually like to use it quite a bit. So yeah, probably not going to be doing anything with that. But anyway, as I said before, we are having a slight problem with money, as you can no doubt tell. Money is becoming a little bit of an issue, so I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do about that. But what I would like to do is find a tournament potentially, because obviously we've done a couple of tournaments in the past, well, only one in this series, but I would generally like to do maybe a maximum of like 5 or something like that. I think we've done 2 actually in this series so far, but I failed in one of them, so that doesn't count, does it? Does it count? I think it, maybe it does. Maybe it does. All right. So we are now in Kuzate territory, which is maybe going to make things a little bit easier for us, because obviously the Tetsujin are pretty good units and I'm not used to fighting them yet. So that's obviously going to be a bit of a thing there. All right. So we're going to go for like 500 gold or something like that for the first bet, because you never know when I'm going to fail. There's a lot of opportunity for me to do that. All right. So we're against the Kuzate archer right here. In the head, yes, that's what you get. Now, I can't believe that he actually allowed me to do that. Okay, this guy's a spearman, so he might actually have a little bit more pole arm skill. Ooh, yeah, as you could tell, he was much better than the previous opponent. And there you go. All right, oh dear. Okay, so yes, a Tetsujin mounted longbowman. Yes, that guy's gotten through. This is going to be a bit problematic. Okay, we've got a bow. I hope he doesn't have a bow, that's all I can say. I've got a sword as well, so I'm going to try and maximize my damage. Nice. Yes, there we go. That's what we needed. That is what we needed. Okay, come on now. Let's try and eliminate the... Wait a minute. Is he on my team? The mounted longbowman is actually on my team. That's fantastic. I had no idea. Oh, yes. We got a good hit on that guy. He's just a spear infantry, so he shouldn't really be able to do too much with his bow skill. Gonna get out my bow and see if we can maybe do some damage. There's no way. I have no skill in this. Yeah, as you could see, it's frankly terrible. Oh, I did hit him. Oh, nice. I got 8 points? 8 points? Oh, wow. Okay, I have no focus points in bows as far as I'm aware. So that's quite amazing. I'm actually kind of surprised that we haven't even killed this guy yet. I mean, I know he's on a horse and everything, but I'm kind of surprised that no one has stopped him. There we go. Taking him down. That's not too bad. And we gain huge amounts of experience from getting these kills, which is always nice. Alright. We're now up against the Tetsujin mounted longbowman and the trained archer. This is going to be problematic. Very, very problematic. Ooh, 75 damage. That was nice. Ooh, okay. Almost died. That's not so nice. Okay, here we go. He's got a shield. Why are they just standing there? Did you see that? They just stood there for a second? It's like they were waiting for me or something. That was kind of weird. All right, but there we go. We actually got through, finally. Okay, let's just bet another 500 or so. And Kuzate Spearman, here we go. All right, so he's going to have a pretty decent polearm skill, so we've got to be very careful. We do not want to kill his mount if we can help it, because if we kill his mount, he's going to have an overwhelming advantage on foot. I know that sounds weird, but generally, spearmen on foot are much more dangerous than if they're on a mount. Because you're going to use your speed to try and kill him, but he has dialed in accuracy when it comes to taking out cavalry. He's used to it. He's always on his feet, always attempting to murder cavalry that try to lance him to death. And he's very ready, you know, he's very ready. Anyway, there you go. We did gain almost 8,000 gold. Technically, I could have gained more, as you could no doubt tell, with the initial bet. But again, I don't want to go overboard. I don't want to go overboard in any way here. I just want to try and survive as best as I can and then go from there. Okay, so polearm attacks that deal over 25 damage have a 25% chance to dismount cavalry. That actually sounds pretty good. Bonus to pushing opponents with a successful thrust attack with polearms. Okay, so I'm probably going to go for this one. Polearm attacks, 25% chance to dismount cavalry. I think that seems pretty good. So we're going to take that. And we're also going to take a one-handed perk as well. 2% swing speed. Yes, we will be going for the 2% swing speed because I'm never going to be using an axe or a mace, I don't think. And we're otherwise going to be specking more points into... I'm actually not sure what to spec it into, to be honest. Trade at the moment is basically negligible. We could go for leadership, but leadership at the moment isn't going to happen yet because I don't have the ability to create an army yet. But I will soon, so it might actually make sense for me to do that. I might go for some riding skill. I'm going to go for some leadership just to prepare for that. But we're also going to be specking a little bit more into endurance there too. Okay, that seems pretty good to me. Let's move on and see if I can maybe level up the remaining little troops that we've gained for that quest. Ah, there we go. All right, so I just auto-resolved against a pack of looters. This was the third pack that I had already fought in auto-resolve, and now we have all of the borrowed troops leveled up because I basically moved them to around the top of the party, and that obviously made a bit of a difference in them entering the fight, or at least I hoped so, entering the fight a little bit earlier and gaining the experience that was required. So send the troops back. There we go. We gain 2,700 almost, which is very nice. And how much Oh, there we go. Look at that. I only need 2 renown. That's fantastic. Okay, so we're going to go over to Akalat once again because I actually forgot to pick up my brother. Yes, because he's basically just waiting there, and he is an absolute monster, as you can see right here. His stats are insane, so I would like to be able to welcome him with open arms into our army. He's going to be a very, very good person to have as one of the first leaders of one of our parties, because that's what I'm going to try and do once again, the same sort of strategy that I had in the Duelist series, where I'd create a party out of some clan members and then create an army out of those clan members so that I wouldn't need influence to be able to, you know, initiate the army creation function. So once I become a vassal of the Tetsujin, then I should be able to do that without too many issues. Okay, so there he is. Let's take him into our party. There's actually a surgeon here. This guy's got 80 medicine. All right, that sounds pretty good to me. I'm actually going to take this guy. He's only 443. Why was the other girl so extremely expensive? I have no idea, but okay. Marauders, no. Step Bandits, no. All right, that's absolutely fine. And we now just need to make sure that they have good gear. I'm pretty sure these guys do not have good gear. They're probably going to be the bottom of the barrel. Yes, indeed. They are the bottom of the barrel in many respects, but not in the armor department at the moment. We're going to be, you know, giving them some good stuff to replace what they had before. And hopefully it's going to be good for them. Okay, let's have a look. He's got some actually decent boots. Nothing great, but decent. Not too bad. Does he have bow skill? Actually, I'm not sure whether he has bow skill, but I'm going to give him a katana. He can keep his shield. I'll take the Highland Spike Club because I don't really want any of my companions using weapons that are not in keeping with the theme, even though technically they are not required to follow the theming, in my opinion. I feel like I'm the only one that should really be following it. Anyway, let's continue to outfit our forces. I don't think I have anything really good for him, but it's going to be a major upgrade anyway, so I think that's decent enough. And maybe I've got a good helmet? No. I actually have pretty terrible helmets for him now. So he's just going to have to make do with that. I mean, he is a surgeon, so I suppose he might very well stay at the back of the back of the battlefield, potentially. I mean, that would be quite nice for him. And we're just going to give him a katana once again. Do I have a shield for him? No, I do not have a shield for him. Well, he's going to have to brave the battlefield without anything. Ah, that sounds absolutely fantastic, doesn't it? I'm sure he's looking forward to it. All right, so just before we enter Tetsujin territory once again, I have leveled up my scouting skill to 50, so let's see what we want to do here. Ah, yes, okay, so generally, Okay, I'm actually not sure which one to take here. Both of these, okay, so now here's the thing. In the Duelist series, I was looking at this and I said, I think that this one is pretty awful. I think that this particular secondary ability, which is once per day when you enter a town, you have a 50% chance to increase the clan's relation with a notable by one. Right. So initially I thought to myself that this was going to be basically useless. I thought this was terrible. Terrible, terrible skill. However, I have revised my thought on that, and I actually think it is quite useful, because over time, when you enter these towns, it is going to add up. And even if it is once per day, even if it's a 50% chance, it's actually going to add up by a pretty significant amount, and you'll be surprised at how much relation you have with each of these NPCs that you can, you know, then recruit people from, and gradually you're going to have so much relation with them, you'll be able to recruit from every single tier that you would ever want. So that's the reason why I'm going to be taking this. The other one is once per day when you enter a village, you have a 50% chance to increase the clan's relation with a notable by one. So that's obviously very good if you want to focus on noble units or anything like that, or not recruiting in bulk, but being a little bit more selective about targeting your recruitment options. But I'm going to be taking the town one because I'm primarily going to be going to towns. Generally, if you're a trader or something like that, then you might very well want to take the other option. But as you can see, I did level up a little bit with this guy, and while they may not be the most influential people right now, it is going to be increasing over a certain period of time. All right. Oh, look at that. Deliver the herd to Mekeb. Okay, this is actually going to be pretty good. So 10 step horses should be fine. Hopefully we'll get some renown for this as well. I mean, Mekeb is only over... Oh, yes. Mekeb is actually very far. All right, so we sold 5 of them for 1,400, which is generally what you want to do if you want to make the most of these things. And we're going to be delivering this to Junjad, the Gutting Knife. He is a gang leader, so there we go. There we are. Very nice indeed. Okay, so do they have a tournament going on here? Yes, they do indeed have a tournament going on here. So if I were to do this, technically what I could do is I could enter a very small fight and just get the renown that I need. And I think I might do that rather than going into another tournament, to be honest. Alright, so I just fought some Tetsujin Vagrants, just an auto-resolve, very, very quick and easy, because I wanted to be able to loot this armor and potentially outfit our surgeon in some better stuff, and indeed we did get something from there, so that's really nice. And now I should be able to move on back to Tetsujin territory and hopefully become something in the hierarchy of the faction, mainly a vassal. I think that would be quite nice. So let's hope that there's going to be a vassal around here somewhere that I can speak to. All right, so I thought it might be quite fun to actually get into a real battle here, so not a bandit hideout and not a, you know, not a tournament or anything like that. So generally, I'm going to try to level up some of my lesser used skills, in other words, my polearm, maybe my crossbow as well, because I personally like using the crossbow quite a bit, even though I'm not really that good at it. And 160 experience, really? Oh, there we go, 585. Wow, it seems like I get a lot more experience for actually getting killing blows. I wonder whether that's actually a real thing or whether it's just my imagination. I'm not entirely sure, but there you go. That was super easy. We did get 5.3 renown. That was a slightly larger party of the bandits in the area than is actually usual. Usually you're going to see guys that are around 6 to 7 strong, but I've been seeing a lot bigger parties. So that's actually really nice, because that means that we have a much more, shall we say, lucrative source of renown and money and all that sort of thing. Okay, so this is actually a really, really nice weapon. I think I might use this, but it's a saber. It's not a katana, as far as I'm aware. I mean, if this was a, I'm not sure. I would like to use it, actually. I'm going to use it, and we'll see how it actually works, because maybe it's not going to be as fun to use as the katana or something like that, and we'll need to swap it out again, but yeah. Anyway, going to continue my search. Alright, so here we go. I finally found a vassal of the faction, and we are now going to be pledging allegiance. You need to talk to our leader, Hanzo, on this matter. He is currently... are you serious? Where is that? That's all the way over... Oh, you scoundrels. They're absolute scoundrels, aren't they? Alright, I'll try and see where... It's amazing that I actually was speaking to this specific guy way back, and now, all of a sudden, I need to speak to him to be able to make the pledge. That is hilarious. Alright, so I finally found him. I had to bribe some of the guards to be able to get into the castle keep, but here he is. Okay, so there's something I'd like to discuss. I have a proposal that benefits us both. No, I actually don't want to do that, but it wouldn't be too bad if I gave him a dinar. Yeah, that's not good. That doesn't work anymore, unfortunately. It used to be that you'd get some charm skill and some relation with the guy if you just gave him one dinar, but now, no, that doesn't work anymore. Alright, so I'm going to pledge allegiance, and here we go. I'm ready. Let's do it. Okay, fantastic, fantastic. Okay, so we have now joined, and I am now a vassal of the Tetsujin. And that means that we are now at war against the Azurai, as you can see right there. And we can now see all of the armies of the Tetsujin, and we can see exact locations of them. So we can go and assist them whenever we like. I'm very much looking forward to it. And with that will be it for this episode. I thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.